Hello, welcome to a new episode. Today we'll continue with the topic of the logistic regression, part 3, confusion matrix. In the logistic regression, the dependent variable can only take values 1 and 0. Thus, we are talking about a binary classification problem. Then a question arises, how do we test the performance of a binary classification method? In order to answer this question, we'll need a confusion matrix and other performance measures. And this is the main subject of today's video. First, let's do a quick recap of the logistic regression. When we say train the regression model, we mean fitting the regression coefficients with the training data. Then we can apply the already trained model and calculate the probability of the dependent variable having value equal to 1. This is what we call forecasting. You can find more details in the previous episodes on the logistic regression. As for testing, there's the so-called in-sample testing. In this case, the testing dataset is the same as the training dataset. The unprimed variables represent the training set, and the primed variables represent the testing set. The purpose of the in-sample testing is to check for the suitability of the regression model. By the way, there is also the so-called out-of-sample testing. In this case, we have a training data set and a testing data set which do not overlap with each other. The purpose of the out-of-sample testing is to generalize the regression model. Okay, now it's time to go through an example on the Excel spreadsheet. We have the Excel file named Example Logistic Regression Test. This is the same data we had used in the previous two episodes on the logistic regression. We have three independent variables, x1, x2, and x3, and one dependent variable, y. We have in mind the in-sample testing, so the same data set is used for training and testing. Now, let's do the test using PrimaXL. We go to the PrimaXL tab, click on it to bring up its ribbon menu. Then we click on the arrow under the button named Logistic and then select Test. A menu form appears. This menu form is quite similar to the ones we have seen so far. At the top, we should give the cell ranges of the training data set, both for X and Y. Next, we should give the cell ranges of the testing set. However, as we mentioned, we'll do in-sample testing. So, we check on this box which says test set is the same as a training set. Finally, we should specify the location of the result output. Now, there's a very important detail. You see this number which is labeled cutoff? This number gives the probability threshold. A forecast probability above this will be identified as 1, while below it will be identified as 0. For the time being, let's just leave its value as 0.5. Let's fill out the rest of the form. We can click on the small button and bring up the range input form, where we can easily enter the cell range by selecting. Okay, I think we are ready. Now just press the run button. Excellent, we have the result. Let's just focus on the result as shown here. In this result output, there's a confusion matrix, and there are some other performance measures. The confusion matrix is a 2x2 matrix. Let's see what each one of these matrix elements means. this element is called true positive. It counts the actual ones they were correctly classified. And this element is called true negative. It counts the actual zeros they were correctly classified. This another element is called false positive. It counts the actual zeros they were misclassified as ones. Finally, this element is called false negative. It counts the actual ones they were misclassified as zeros. Then, these are the relevant measures for the binary classification. We have the sensitivity, which is calculated as true positive divided by the sum of the true positive and the false negative. As we can see here, we have the specificity, which is given by this formula, positive predictive rate, negative predictive rate, and the accuracy, which is probably the most important performance measure. Here, its value is 0.74. Its formula says, sum the true positive and the true negative, and divide by the sum of all the matrix elements. The accuracy is a very important measure, so let's bring back the confusion matrix and see where it comes from. The accuracy measure tells us how big the diagonal elements are compared to the rest of the matrix. Okay, a couple of more examples. Back to the same Excel file we had before, we will just change the value of the probability cutoff and see how it affects the result. Please remember that we had a cutoff equal to 0.5 before. Also remember the values of the sensitivity, the specificity, and the accuracy. Okay, let's reset the cutoff to 0.7 and rerun. Compared to what we had, the sensitivity decreases while the specificity increases, and the accuracy remains more or less the same. Another run, let's reset the cutoff to 0.3 and run. Here, the sensitivity increases while the specificity decreases, and there is a slight decrease in the accuracy. Okay, finally, a summary. Today, we saw how to test the performance of the binary classification. We used the in-sample testing method. We calculated the confusion matrix and other performance measures. We could see the dependence on the probability cutoff. More about this in the next episode. In the coming episode, we'll try to see how to optimize the binary classification. And we'll discuss about the so-called ROC curve. Great! I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you so much. Until next time, bye.